Get a bang. Get a bang energy.
Bang tastes gross. Shut your ass up. I've never had a Nas and I don't want one.
To be fair, most energy drinks are really gross. I only tolerated a Monster once because it was like $5. Ooh. As I had one Monster once, and it was the equivalent of me taking my Adderall at like 5 p.m. That shit kept me up until like 3 or 4 a.m.
Hi, I'm Dory.
Just do the Yeti mic if it's just gonna be stupid, I guess. I think voice mod is broken. Whatever.
Pablo.
Let me turn on the music.
You want to see something funny?
Sure.
Hold on, I'm gonna put in the bloody TC. Are you ready? Squidney?
Mm-hmm.
Look in the bloody TC.
This is not the right music. It might be a little dramatic, but it's fine. It's fine. I mean, y'all did just have conflict. Anyway. What is it? Oh my god, it's great. That's fucking amazing. That's great. I love that. I love that meme so much. Did you show Ethan that? Please tell me you showed Ethan that.
Ethan sent that to me.
Oh, that's great. I love it. Anyway. Dude, we need that picture of him like this, though. As an icon. Anyway, so. I guess we can get started. Since I haven't heard shit from Ellie, and we're about 7 minutes late.
Bless you.
Thank you. So, everybody, where was it that we left off?
Car.
In the car with the dog. Caden was angry.
Yeah.
Caden is annoyed.
Mm-hmm. That's it?
Yeah.
I mean,
oh, we broke the masquerade on accident.
Wait, how?
I didn't break shit!
Wait,
I
how?
I didn't break shit!
How? Oh yeah! The cameras! Thank you for reminding me of that! I totally forgot about that. Thank you! yeah. Okay. Do y'all remember?
I didn't break shit.
Do y'all remember what happened with Lily, Blanco, and Guy at all?
Blanco almost punched a hole through Doctor's face. And Lily passed out. And Guy,
that guy was just vibing.
Yeah.
Guy gave his high calorie blood.
Okay. Yeah. So, yeah, that that's
somebody what talk. Somebody talk while I find my character sheet.
Well, I'll give more of an in-depth explanation. So last time you all were here, you all decided to split off the party. So three people stayed back with the doctors, and the other three decided to go to, like, a animal shelter that was nearby. You guys were tasked with giving pretty much some kind of animal test subject, in a sense, to the doctors. And also were asked if any of the wolves would like to provide any vitae to the doctors themselves to actually test what's going on and how it might be, how it could be affected by the illness that is going around. you all, Caden, Spaz, and Haytham, and Jason, I believe? Yes, mm-hmm. Jason too. All went to the animal shelter. Y'all really didn't expect much, but you guys ended up finding a dog that seemingly is sick. Not really sure what it could be, but definitely there's something wrong with this dog. After many, many, many minutes of trying to get this dog out and trying to figure it out, y'all were able to eventually get it out. And so are now back in the car and most likely, I assume, heading back towards the doctors. Lily, Guy, and Blanco, they were all at the doctor still. Were very nervous. Specifically, Blanco was very nervous about these doctors. But pretty much what ended up happening is that both Lily and Guy provided their vitae to them so that they may test. Do any kind of tests or whatever. And so 2 seconds while I open up all the character sheets. Also, if any of you guys have upgraded anything, please do me a favor and just, like, put like a fresh character sheet that's been updated into the thing. But that being said, open this. Okay, it's not what I wanted, but sure. but yeah. So, Haytham, Caden,
yes.
Spaz, and Jason, you were all sitting in the car. In the car. Making your way back. It was specifically Guy's car, I believe, that you guys borrowed. And the mood is a little heavy. There's tension in the air, and you all can feel it. I don't know if you guys...
Question. Is Jason still holding the impromptu leash as a wolf?
Yes. It's not changed back. You have basically two dogs in the car.
One of which is holding the other's leash.
What were you saying, Caden? Sorry.
One of which is holding the other's leash.
Yes. So, that is happening currently right now. Is there anything you all would like to say to each other at all?
Haytham is sort of focused on driving right now, but he's making sure to, like, keep flicking his eye at the rear view to, like, pay attention to what's going on in the back.
So, what are we doing with this scary dog afterward?
I don't know. I have no idea, honestly. I'm gonna leave that to PETA in the back seat. And you.
Uh,
Oh. Aiden somehow looks even more upset when you said that. Like, he looked angry, and now he just looks like Grumpy Cat.
Well.
Do you guys want to turn on some tunes?
Sure, why not? Still very annoyed. Just throw something in there.
Is there anything in particular, Spaz, that you would like to play?
I mean, if it fits the mood. Oh, about Taylor Swift's Bad Blood.
Oh my god. Okay.
Does this... Hold on, I wonder.
The copyright is worth it. But the copyright is worth
ooh,
it.
Oh, wait. Never mind.
We'll be talking over it, so you won't get hit.
It's fine. Haytham, you are focused on driving at the moment. But you can kind of hear that Spaz is, like, shuffling through. Like, pretty much trying to connect her phone, I guess. Connect something? Question mark? CD? I don't know.
Is there an oxy cord in this car?
I have no idea, but we're gonna say that it does. We're gonna say that it does. Because I have seen it.
It has cassette players that works as an oxy cord.
Yes, we're gonna say that. And there's a silence for a moment. And then, as Spaz continues to shuffle through, eventually you all start to hear... That's so stupid. You guys start to hear a familiar voice.
Yo.
Even you know who it is. Haytham. And it is... Christ, it's the wrong version. But you know, I don't even care. It's fine.
Haytham irritated for 10 seconds. Then is very confused because he has Kendrick Lamar on the same song as Taylor Swift. He didn't immediately stop the song. And it's like, don't ever put a song with both of them on it. That's disrespectful to Kendrick Lamar.
Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift is ass.
Haytham.
Her music is bad. She says the same thing in every goddamn song. She's literally horrible. Kanye was right. He made her.
Damn, so he had to bring Kanye into this. Okay.
I mean, he's better than Taylor Swift.
There is but a silence in the car now.
Just saying. Taylor Swift wouldn't name her child after Cardinal Direction.
I'm just saying, Taylor Swift doesn't have nearly as many accolades as Kanye West. Or money. Or even quality content.
Caden now looks very confused as to why we are arguing over Taylor Swift.
Caden, it's because now we have bad blood. We used to be mad love, but now look at what you've done.
Haytham,
I don't
hate
think
them
we
literally,
can solve them.
Haytham literally just takes it out. He just takes it out.
Haytham, no! Band-Aids don't fix bullet holes! You live like that, you live with ghosts.
Haytham, Haytham. Is not very impressed with anything this
That needs to be clipped.
Right,
for the love of God, please. I need to clip that. It needs to be clipped. I need to clip that. Anyway. As y'all are having this discussion.
Interesting.
Jason is silently sitting there. He kind of keeps looking back and forth at this conversation. And then he shakes his head.
Paw to the forehead.
Jason, you can't tell me you don't like Taylor Swift. Come on.
There's still just a silence. There's a silence.
You know, Jason, I get it. I get it. You gotta watch the doggo back there.
That being said, you all pull up finally. It feels like it's been an eternity, and it hasn't really even been that long. But you eventually...
Wait, Jason?
Sure. Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna pet Jason. I'm reach back in the little hole or whatever that goes to the back thing and pet Jason.
You can't see this, Faz, but there's just this feeling of just... Jason can't particularly do anything at the moment, so... But there is a feeling in the air that says so much about how he's currently feeling, being treated like a dog. But you all pull up to the actual location that you all were headed back towards. And that being said, you all see the familiar sight of the giant business building. And at least from where you guys left it before, nothing seems to have changed. Haytham, you pull up into a parking spot, put the car in park. And now you all are just sitting there in the car.
Alright. Somebody grab that dog. Let's get in here, give it to them so we can finish with this shit. And Haytham just starts to get out the car while they figure out who's gonna do what with the dog.
Haytham, roll intelligence composure.
Intelligence composure,
Okay. Haytham, as you're stepping out of the car, there are two things that come to mind. One being the fact that Jason and the dog are basically in the trunk, and Jason cannot open the door. Two. All of the things that have been going on lately, in terms of your club, in terms of how people have interacted with you, in terms of just this whole situation in general, yes, you are irritated, but also something about this feels almost familiar. Something about all of these interactions and all of these different weird, stupid situations bring you to a thought of your past. Something in terms of when you were in before you became a hunter in the darkness. And it fills you more with... It reminds you of when you and your war mates would be together in just the dumbest situation, or at least what you thought was dumb, and how there would be these little conflicts, and even in terms of different opinions. And it brings you to the thought of how different life could be, or could have been, if maybe you had stopped it, or if you had actually put yourself, distanced yourself from it. How different would life be now?
All these thoughts running through Hatham's head. He's leaning against the car. He sort of leans back and he just throws his fingers on his temples. Because it's just it's a lot. Just a big, deep... You know, just a big, deep sigh. And he sort of tries to shake it all off. Smacks his face a little bit. Just whispers to himself, oh, you got it. You've been through this before, a couple lifetimes ago. And then... He perks up and he just tries to recompose himself and just throw all those negative, annoyed emotions out. At least until somebody does something to piss him off again.
Gaden, Spaz, what do you guys do? Because you both are sitting both in the car.
I'd probably try to hop out and try to open the trunk, but like carefully crack it first and kind of look in there.
As you open the trunk, all of a sudden there is somewhat of a push, and you can see that the dog that is somewhat contained in a sense starts to attempt to push out to get out. But that being said, there is a bit of a growl from at least what you can assume is Jason, and he is trying his hardest to hold this dog with, or at least the actual leash. Once you get the door open, go on.
Would I see that happening?
Yes, you can hear what's going on since you're still technically kind of in the car.
I'm not gonna do that. That's probably gonna end badly.
I'm gonna need some help with this.
I'll try and, like, scruff the dog. Like, grab it by the scruff. To make it try and make it stop.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
So, mind you, this is... I just want to put this out there. This dog is, like, kind of like a German Shepherd kind of mix. Just so you're aware. Because I don't think anybody remembers that. But, that being said... So, you're going to try to grab the scruff of the dog?
Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking, but...
So... You attempt to help Jason in the back, Caden. And when you do, there is attempts. When you grab onto the back of its neck, pretty much, that dog attempts to kind of turn and try and just make whatever is holding it back let go. And instead, what it does is it attempts to bite you, but instead it misses and grabs the leash. And even then, it's still trying to pull, There is foam dripping from its mouth. But it is definitely somewhat enraged again. Although Jason was able to calm it, or at least keep it from actually doing anything at one point, it has now gotten to a point where it's becoming a little more brave. And so, Haytham, you can hear the commotion that is going on at the moment, and you also heard Spaz say what she said. Are you going to help, or are you just going to stand where you're at?
Haytham takes another sigh, and in his head, he says, "That was a very short-lived moment of peace." And then he walks to the back of the car to sort of see just, like, what the fuck they have going on.
Haytham, when you walk to the car, Spaz has pretty much got the door of the trunk kind of open. It's not fully open, but it is kind of open. You can hear the dog in the car freaking out. It is growling, it is barking, it is being an angry dog. At least from what you can see from the window of the actual back, Caden is also attempting to help Jason, who is also holding onto the leash for the dog.
Haytham is gonna look at those two, back, forth, and he's gonna look at Caden, cock his head to the side a little bit, so like, "So, Steve Irwin, what are you going to do since you wanted to save the dog earlier?" Are you just going to stand there with that blank expression on your face, or are you going to say something back to me? You know, I find it
funny. Genuinely out of character, I don't know what to do because I am not a dog person and I don't know how to take care of animals very well.
Okay, that's fine. I'm still gonna antagonize you though.
But I was gonna say, did you want to roll to like either I don't know.
Roll to like try and figure out how to calm it down a little bit?
Okay. Yeah, we could do that. Do an intelligence composure.
Okay.
If y'all don't ever have an idea of what the hell you're doing, and you really need me to throw you a bone, literally just roll intelligence composure or ask. I was like, literally. And tell me how many successes you have. Big brain. Okay. Caden, when Haytham says that, you have a big brain moment. Right? Big brain. And so, in terms of seeing how this dog is, it's obviously sick, but it also wants to get out. The issue is that you want to be able to contain it. So there's a few options. You all could either kill the dog and call it a day. You could somehow tie the mouth of the dog closed, but that puts all of you at risk. And then y'all could maybe use food to get it away, or to get it to follow at some point, maybe. Or you could just brute force it, grab the dog, and take it inside and just, you know, take your risks.
Haytham, seeing that no progress is being made, he's just gonna go, "Jesus. Okay, y'all, hold the dog here. I'm gonna go downstairs and either find some tranquilizers or some shit to fucking, or some help of some sort to get this goddamn dog downstairs." And then Haytham walks inside, goes all the way to the elevator, takes it down, and like goes to like find the head honcho in charge, or somebody who looks like they know
they're going. Okay. So, Haytham, you make your way into the actual building, make your way down. The white is blinding, but eventually you make your way down the hall and to the actual doctor's domain. And when you walk in, you can see that the doctors are being as busy as usual. They're doing their usual thing. Currently, from what you can see, both Blanco and Guy are kind of vibing.
Yeah.
And on a chair not too far away. Actually, you see Lily sitting in Blanco's arms, being held. And Guy is just vibing.
Oh boy, I wonder what I missed in this short amount of time. Ignoring them and whatever wacky, goofy, silly things they have going on, I go up to one of the scientists. I'm like, hey, do y'all have like a tranquilizer or like a sedative, like something I can use on this goddamn dog?
So when you walk up to one of the random doctors that are kind of just doing their own thing, they look at you, obviously, dressed in their little plague doctor outfit. Yeah. And they tilt their head slightly. And then there's like a moment of just pause. And then you see that he does this. He does this, and then, or they, and they walk over to what looks like a little table kind of cabinet thing. And he crouches down, goes through it, and eventually pulls out what looks to be a syringe and a bottle. He walks back to you and then holds them both out to you.
I take them from his hands, I say thank you, I'll be back in a moment. And then I turn around, go back to the elevator, go up, and go back out to meet with them.
Okay, so you make your way back up. It's a grueling process to be the one that seems to be in charge at this point. But you make your way back out to the rest of the party. And you walk your way back to the car. Spaz, while kind of holding the door of the car to make sure the dog doesn't get out, Haytham walks up next to you.
Hey.
I filled up the syringe with an appropriate amount while I responded to Spaz, hey. So, they didn't really say anything to me, but they gave me this. And, so now I'm gonna stick the goddamn dog and hope that he goes night-night long enough for us to get him inside. And then after filling up the needle an appropriate amount for the size of the dog, Haytham says, all right, hold him still. Spaz, you're gonna have to use some of that wolf girl strength. Don't turn in the middle of the street though, dear God. You already turned it at the vet, and I don't know how we're gonna handle that. So,
furry con?
What? No, I don't think that's. Listen, we're probably gonna have Esteban coming to shoot us again. Okay, Still, just hold the dog and make sure that it doesn't bite me, because it's gonna lash out.
I mean, okay, alright, I'll try to do something.
As sturdy as you can, don't let it move. And I tell Jason, get in the dog's face so it doesn't try anything, just growl at it or whatever the fuck you have to do.
I'm literally in a spot where it can't bite me and I would know where to put the needle.
Oh. Okay, why didn't you say anything, Caden? And then Haytham cocks his head again, hands Hayden the needle and the syringe. Alright, go ahead, it's all you, champ.
You know, wait, since Caden technically has a little more knowledge on this, do you think maybe they should look at the chemical before we just stick this thing in there?
Honestly, I don't give a fuck. Y'all can do whatever you're gonna do with this dog.
Christ.
If it'll make y'all feel better to do that, then go ahead. And then Hatham, after handing it off, he just sits there, arms crossed. And he's just sort of looking on, so what do you need me to do, Caden?
Sid, what does the vial say?
Why don't you roll me a... intelligence... science, and I'll let you add medicine to it if you have that.
Intelligence science?
Yep, and medicine.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
That is... oh my god. Okay, so that's 4 successes.
So, in looking at... taking the vial and the syringe from... Haytham, you look over the bottle, and looking it over, it's definitely a tranquilizer of some sort, but looking at the syringe and then looking at like the actual little details on the actual bottle itself, there's a specific amount to actually cause or induce, like, you know, sleep, but then there's also
an amount to induce, like, heart failure.
Yes. Yes. And so, I assume Haytham filled up the syringe already?
He filled up halfway.
So, in looking at the syringe and looking at the bottle, at least the amount from what you can see on the syringe, it doesn't really have... it looks like the syringe has been worn, literally. Like, the actual thing. So, the measurements are a little bit... annoying
hard
to see.
See.
Yes. But at least from what you can tell, definitely this is an okay amount. This will not kill this animal.
I'm gonna give it the stuff then.
Okay.
I'm gonna do it in the flank because it's still biting onto the leash thing, right?
It is still attempting to, yes. It is still kind of trying to get away.
Okay, I'm gonna shoot it in the flank then. Okay. Just real quick.
Pew!
In the butt.
So, as you stick this needle into this dog, all of a sudden, there is a pull from the dog itself, and what ends up happening is that, although it's still, it basically attempts to rip the actual leash, and you can only assume that it's gotten vicious because it felt pain.
Yeah.
And so it is now gotten a little more intense. Spaz, why don't you roll a strength of strength dex? No, strength stamina. Sorry. Okay. There is a massive, like, from what you can, well, what you feel from holding this door, there is a push. There is a hard push. Even though there was that hard push, you were able to hold the door down. This dog is, at this point, kind of losing its shit. And at this point, it takes Jason to at least corner it as much as he can in this vehicle to keep it contained, but it is desperately trying to flail around and get out. After a few minutes, it seems as though the aggression starts to calm. And when it starts to calm, eventually the dog almost lays down for a moment in its little corner and passes out. And you can tell it's still alive, at least for the moment, because it is definitely breathing.
Fucking finally. Alright, let's get this goddamn dog inside, and I'll reach in, just pick him up before anybody can say anything, and I just start to fucking carry him in.
Okay. Cade and Spaz, what are you guys doing?
I guess I'll be following along.
Yeah. With the stuff that Hatham gave me in hand, just follow.
Y'all make your way back into the building. What?
Nothing.
We didn't
it's
leave
fine.
Jason out there, right?
No, Jason is also following behind.
Two dogs in the hub.
He's falling behind. He's still in his wolf form. But you all make your way into the business building. You pile up all in the elevator. And I want Caden and I want Spaz to roll intelligence composure. Ethan, why don't you also roll an intelligence composure? So, as you all are standing in the elevator, Spaz, you had something on your mind, but I think with all the commotion, all the what was going on, it's kind of just faded at this point. And so you stand there, awkwardly staring at the walls of the elevator. Caden. As you were staring at the walls of the elevator as well, you can see a reflection. And standing behind you is pretty much Hatham with the dog. You think about how these thoughts start to flood your mind about everything that's happened so far, and it's only been like a day or two. And a lot of it still doesn't make sense to you, honestly. A lot of this doesn't make sense. How you feel about what is currently going on and about all of these weird shenanigans, you don't know why, but it, in a sense, it rubs you the wrong way. All of this is kind of rubbing you the wrong way. But at this point, they're all you have at this moment. Hatham.
Yes.
As you're holding this dog, you start to think about, how the Invictus has been nothing but a shit show and being nothing but just basically bullies. You think about all the different covenants that you've at least interacted with. The only one that you can think of that you haven't really interacted with so far, as much at least, is Dodu Dracul and also the Circle of the Crone. Circle of the Crone was in a negative space, and the Ordu Dracul was more of a positive, but not really a completely positive space. And this gets you thinking. What if there was something that wasn't these choices? The Carthians, the Odu Dracul, the Invictus, and the Circle of the Crone. And this starts to fill your mind.
Okay.
What if there was something different? And as all of you kind of stand there in silence, there's a ding. And the doors open. And before you all, you see the long white hallway that y'all are becoming a lot more accustomed to.
You know, I've been thinking, guys. Did anyone bring Jason's clothes?
He's naked all the time. I don't think it really matters at this point. And I feel like the nice scientist here will have some extra clothes for our neighborhood nudists.
I mean, I guess you have a point. Who here hasn't seen Jason naked yet?
I wish I could say I had, but I have.
Spaz is gonna look over at Caden.
I'm also gonna look over at Caden. Okay, have you seen Jason naked yet?
No.
Huh. That's strange.
Ah, first time.
Don't worry, you're gonna become a frequent flyer very soon.
So y'all are standing pretty much with the elevator wide open. I assume you guys are walking towards the actual doctor's lanes. Okay. So you all make your way back or walk down that hall. And as you're walking down the hall, eventually you reach the doors. And Haytham, I assume you're going first in.
With yeah.
The, yeah. You walk in.
Go ahead. No, you go.
Haytham, as you walk in, you see that a lot of the doctors kind of look, they pretty much look towards you, seeing that you are holding this big-ass
large dog.
Yes, you are carrying this big-ass dog. Guy and Blanco also look, hearing that you've come in. Who's coming in second? Would it be Spaz? Would it be Caden?
I'll go in second.
Okay. Caden, as you follow behind Haytham, you can see that the doctors are specifically staring at Haytham. And you can see the rest of the party kind of chilling near, kind of, not too far back, but, like, towards the wall. You can see that Lily is in Blanco's arms at the moment. And also, Spaz, as you walk in after him, you see the exact same thing. You see the exact same thing, and pretty much Lily's passed out in Blanco's arms.
Spaz is gonna run up there. What happened to Lily?
Spaz, as you run up, you see that Blanco looks at you.
Blanco voice in me, we need it.
Friend 4.
Nah, you gotta put some oomph on that shit.
I don't have a deep voice, that's the problem.
Oh, well, you better make it deep. I wanna hear your best friend 4.
Friend 4.
I want.
Is sleeping. They.
What did they do?
They took blood. And then you see that. Oh, go on. Sorry.
Why did they take so much? If Spaz is gonna start looking really pissed.
You hear Guy pipe up. Well, they didn't really take that much. I think she saw the blood,
and passed out. I think. I'm not sure. She was fine for a second, and then when they started taking it, she went out.
I was gonna try to shake Lily a little bit. Wake up!
Hitham's gonna look on. He's gonna look on for a second, and then he's gonna go. Anyway, here's the dog that y'all ordered. You might wanna, get it done while it's still asleep, because he's a feisty one.
So, I'll start with Hatham. Hatham, you say this to the doctors, and then at least like a handful of them just come up to you. They pretty much take the dog from you. And as they do, you can see that they're all starting to prep. Others around are starting to prep and do different things. The main doctor approaches you, and looks to you. I appreciate all of your help. I think with all of this, we have taken the vitae from the wolves, and with this we should be able to at least see if it's even possible to infect others.
Alright.
As of right now, I don't have any more work for you. But in the future, I'll definitely be contacting you once we figure out anything. But
no.
If you would like to communicate or even figure out if any other areas are being affected, or any other covenants are, please let us know. And if you can keep note of any high exposures, let us know.
Alright. And I exchange numbers with the guy, give him my personal number. If you need us, just call me, and then I'll round everybody up and get them all here.
Tears are gonna start to like well up in Spaz's eyes, seeing Lily like this, and she is gonna come up to like where Hatham is by this doctor guy. Who do you think you are? You just fucking took her vitae and you don't even give her a cookie or fluids or anything? You're just gonna leave her like this? What the fuck?
Spaz?
No! This is not cool! I am not happy right now.
You should know that.
We are helping you. The least you can do is give her a fucking cookie.
I don't think they have cookies down here, Spaz. We can get her a cookie. We will
help
get her a cookie.
Do something!
Spaz, she is okay.
Spaz is gonna turn back and point. She is unconscious. What the fuck?
Some people are like that.
We're sticking our neck out for you here.
Spaz, look at me. Look at me. Focus. She is okay. I can smell her. She is alive. Okay? I can smell the blood pumping through her veins. She is just fine. She is literally just blood shy. Every time there's been conflict or blood, what happens? She either freezes up or passes out. You're her friend. You should know that better than anybody at this point. Why the hell are you growling at me? Hazel's just gonna look at her like, Mish, what? She's fine. You know that. You can hear her breathing. You can see that she's okay.
Spaz is shaking right now.
Come on, let's go get
Spaz,
her. Let's go get her a cookie and a drink.
Do you feel that you are at the point where you are, like, not, like,
You're not able to contain yourself just normally. Because if so, I'm going to need you to roll a composure, resolve. And I guess you could add willpower to it if you want. Like the total of the willpower you have to your dice pool.
Okay, well, I guess I'm rolling.
Oh, shit. Oh. Caden, you are witnessing all this, by the way. You're just like... Is there any reaction, anything you want to... God
damn, that's a lot of dice. Ooh.
Well, shit. Okay.
Caden would have the wide-eyed blank expression on his face just because he's never seen Spaz this mad.
Spaz, you are filled with rage. You are angry. You see someone that you truly, deeply care about pass the fuck out. This environment and this whole vibe of all of these doctors and all of the vampires that you've experienced so far irritates the fuck out of you. But Haytham is right. You take a moment, deep breath, and although you are still angry, you're able to contain yourself. And you do not end up going into a raged frenzy. But while you were stuck on this moment, there is a stir. There's a stir from Lily specifically. And she...
Uh-oh, chili dogs.
God damn it.
Fuck! Literally!
I don't even know why I did that. It just, I don't know. My brain just said do it. And so I had to do it.
There is a small little, like, from Lily. And then you hear Blanco say, "Friend four, friend four." You see that he looks for like the closest chair and just puts her down. And although she's sort of out of it, she shakes her head, rubs her face a little bit, and then kind of like looks around. What happened?
Haytham, who seems to be sighing a lot tonight, looks over at Lily, and he says, "Hey, look, could you do me a favor and tell your friend that you're okay? Because she's about to burn the whole establishment down if she doesn't hear it straight from your mouth."
What do you mean?
And I point at Spaz. I'm like looking at her. You can practically see the hair standing up on the back of her neck.
Spaz, you make eye contact with Lily, who's still somewhat out of it. What happened? Are you okay? The voice is not coming out right. I don't remember what happened. I just know that they were taking blood and then everything went black. Did I pass out? And then she looks over at Blanco. And then Guy just is like, "Yep." You see that she's, like, rubbing her face now, and, like, she tries to get up quickly, and when she does, she stumbles a little bit. Shit.
Sorry to interrupt you, Sid, but Ellie just said that the music isn't working on stream.
It's not? What? Motherfucker. Is it just that low? It's probably that low. 2 seconds. Oh, shit! Thank you, Ellie, for that fucking 100 biddies. Why isn't the music playing? I think it was just really low. Sorry. But yeah. So. She stumbles a little bit.
Spaz is gonna sigh. And just look at the doctor. I'm sorry, your bedside manner just needs work. Then she's gonna make her way over to Louie.
Hey, don't mumble under the blowing of the cab. Do people speak English?
You see the doctor. He went from pretty much the feeling that you could feel from this man, even though you can't see his expression because of the mask. You can almost sense, like, there's more of a calm again. Well, maybe we should keep some things. We're not particularly used to providing our subjects with, well, maybe not subjects. We're not used to having patients that are alive most of the time. But I will keep note of this, at least for the future. Anyway, Haytham, thank you, and thank your friends for me, for all their work.
No problem, Doc. Anytime. And then, like, I look at the rest of them. I just, like, throw my hand up and do, like, the rounded up motion. I point towards the elevator, and then I throw my hands in my pockets, and I just start to walk towards the elevator.
Spaz, as you walk up to walk back to Lily, she looks at you with concern. Why did you get so mad? What happened? I mean, I'm fine. I just blood freaks me out a little bit. Okay? It really does.
Sydney, Claire.
I showed up here and you were just unconscious and I don't know what happened. And I was just livid. They were supposed to take care of you and they didn't do anything.
I mean, I'm fine.
And I thought you were dead at first too. That didn't help.
Why would I be dead?
I don't know. Like, the whole virus thing and all that stuff going on, and I just...
What?
I mean, I'm fine. I can take care of myself. I just get a little freaked out by blood. For fuck's sake, Vajay, stop! I'm trying to be serious! No. I'm trying so hard to be serious!
Be serious, I'm talking to Ellie right now!
Whatever. Anyway. Anyway. It's not a big deal. Anyway, did you guys end up getting what we needed?
No, I forgot I walked towards the elevator after I threw the roundup sign.
I mean, she's talking to Spaz.
We got the dog, if that's what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's all we needed, right? Yeah, that's all we needed. Wait, do we have any other plans
about... I'm
gonna
be completely honest, it was such an event, I forgot.
What do you mean?
Jason's naked, by the way.
Wait, what? Again? Again?
Yeah, again.
Jason just sits on the floor, just kind of vibing at this point. He doesn't know how to turn back. But what he does do is he looks at all of you and then he follows Haytham.
Well, you know, that's kind of my first thought there too. I'm like, why would... Okay.
Would what?
Nothing. I was just thinking, like, why Jason didn't turn back, but you know what? I'm sure the coal tile is nice.
For clarification, he's still in wolf form, right?
Yeah, pretty much. You guys have a fucking dog, basically, following you around at this point.
Big-ass dog.
Big-ass dog, yeah. He really doesn't know what he's doing, does he?
Hey, do you think they neuter animals here?
They what?
Never mind.
What? Aiden was about to follow Haytham, and then he heard that and was just like, are you gonna... Never mind.
You know, I don't even want to know. And Lily starts to follow to, like, catch up with Haytham. Okay, so do we have any other plans that we're going to be doing?
Off the top of my head, there's nothing that I can particularly think of. Well, there's a couple things that we can do. We can explore the Carthian area more and see if there's anything we can get into before the end of the night. Two, we can go by... No, Caden's College is super far and out the way out. We wouldn't make it back before daylight. There is always our dual Dracul lady, but you know, that's a little sketchy right now, so we just met her. So, I mean, there's a couple of things we can do. It just depends on how everybody's feeling tonight, honestly.
I mean, we don't have any more leads on the lost pup, so...
Oh. Looks like we're a little dead out in the air right now.
I mean, how's your car looking?
Well, my car's still fucked the hell in back, and it's still sitting at the reservation. For some reason, Haytham feels like he should check his phone. He checks his phone.
Haytham, after all the commotion and everything that's been going on, you didn't happen to notice or hear any kind of notification at all? But you do have a few notifications. You have one text message from Quinn specifically. You have another from Jessica. And you have another from an unknown number.
I want to look at the message from the unknown number first.
Okay. You don't recognize this number at all. Like, you, it's not in your contacts, and you don't recognize it at all. The area code itself looks like it... Yeah, you're not really sure, honestly, where the area code is from. But, in looking at the message itself, it says a few words. And these words say...
Google.
Google, just show me this guy's balls.
It pretty much says, "Hi. Look forward to seeing you soon, Haytham." That's it.
Haytham does two question. Wait.
This is music. Hey. That's music.
Yes, but it's all the music. Yes. Haytham sends two question marks and put the word doc, and then one more question mark, and then he sends on that message, and then he checks Quinn's message.
So Quinn's message, it pretty much says, "I've got you for the guns that you asked for. I'll have them delivered soon, or I'll deliver them soon."
All right.
And then also, so I've been kind of thinking. So I have some information you might be interested in. This kind of has to do with something that I had told Mama Lobo about before. I don't know if she told you all. If I'm honest, I don't remember. But if you want more info, give me a call.
Another science case, Haytham. At this point, he's gonna run out of air in his lungs. But before doing that, he checks that other message.
From Jessica?
Yeah.
So, this one says, "Hey, I hope everything's going good. So I've got the plan set. I don't know if I told you this, but I got the plan set for the masquerade. I've made flyers. They're up everywhere. That one lady hasn't come by recently." This music does not fit the mood. If I'm honest, I kind of miss seeing your face around here. And there's a little heart.
Haytham smiles at the text, scratches his head a little bit, and,
You good there?
Yeah, I'm good. And he turns and he looks at Lily, shitty-eating grin. I'm good.
Anyone else just knows Haytham got a lot more happier?
Yeah, that's what I noticed.
Yeah, I am significantly happier right now. Very much so. Why? You may not ask, but I am. So everybody load up in the car, and I'll figure out where we're going. And then Haytham texts her back like, yeah, we should either meet up soon or, you know, something, you know. It's been in like 2-3 days. It'd be nice to see you too. He puts a winky face emoji in the little heart on the, you know, the fucking greater than and the goddamn 3 on that bitch. Makes a little goofy heart, and he sends that off. And then he goes to call Quinn. And any smile and any happiness he just had instantly gone.
So you're calling Quinn?
Yeah.
Okay. So everybody, I assume, is going to pile back into the car.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want to just yet. Hold on. Hey, Blanco, can you carry me to the car like you're carrying Lily?
Wait, which, hold, 2 seconds. I need to check something. 2 seconds! So I can play the part correctly. Wrong thing. Where is it?
But, friend three, you... Why?
Actually, it kind of looked fun.
Okay. And then you see that he just like, whatever. And then he pretty much picks you up a bridal style.
Whee!
And you know what? Why don't you roll a perception for me?
I can hear it now. What are you doing? No!
Shut up. You are enjoying yourselves. You were vibing. They were vibing.
I may have not rolled the right amount of dice for that. I think I just rolled wits. My bad.
Well, then roll your extra dice. Damn.
Well, nope, I'm just vibing.
You are being held bridal style by this big ass man. This big ass man.
Oh my god, this is amazing. This is what it's like to be tall?
Yes.
Since I'm also outside the car, and you know, I'm looking around, do I notice the seething face of Lily?
Do you wanna roll a perception?
Yeah.
Oh.
I notice.
Hatham. Spaz doesn't notice this, nor does Blanco, because he doesn't really particularly. He's only focused on what he's doing. But there is Lily. Arms crossed. She is seething. She is seething. And also, she's, like, looking away at this situation. Almost like she's trying to contain herself, but it's not working out very well.
I walk over to Lily, and I, like, do the whisper, and I go,
"So you really just gonna let him grab your girl like that? Because if that was me, you know, I wouldn't let it roll like that."
What do you mean? No. Wait, no. You see that? You see that she literally just ends up covering her face and then shakes her head and then just makes her way to the car, gets in, doesn't say anything else.
And then I like lean in through her window.
I'm just saying, I mean, like, if it was me, I wouldn't let it slide like that.
Shit didn't even grin on his face knowing he's instigating the hell out of this situation for no reason. And then he goes back to what he was doing before before she can, like, really say anything in rebuttal.
Really has this face. Just Anyway, Kate, I assume you're getting in the. You're either in the car or got in the car.
Yeah.
Okay. So you probably. Well, did you want to hear this conversation?
He probably would have been sitting right behind her or something, so. Depending on how big the car is. I forgot how big the car is.
I forgot how big it is, too, but it's kind of. It's pretty. It's not huge, but it's not small either.
It's like a 6-seater or something.
Mm-hmm. And so, you could barely hear it, but you did hear a little bit of what Haytham was saying to Lily specifically. And at least judging by the back of her head, you can kind of see that she is like, you can feel the intense emotions coming from her. Spaz, Blanco pretty much carries you over to the car.
Did Gwen ever pick up?
Oh, right. I didn't know that you called her right then and there. Okay, mm-hmm. So Haytham, you get in the car, and you dial up Quinn's number. And as you do that...
I'm in the driver's seat because I still got the keys.
Yeah. So you get in the car, and as you get in the car, you dial up Quinn. There's a ring, there's another ring, and then there's a... Hello?
Hey, I just saw your text message, what's up?
Okay. So. I assume you're interested, right?
Somewhat.
Okay. Well, let's make a deal. Right? You okay with that? I do work in business.
What the deal is. You do.
Okay. So, if I give you this information, I want you to do one thing.
Depending on what it is, we might have a deal.
You didn't hear it from me, and you found out by some other vampire person whatever you need to do to make it up. Got it?
All right.
Okay. So
well, before she goes, before she continues on any longer, Haytham pulls down his notifications and just hits the screen record while the rest of the conversation is going on.
Okay. So, pretty much what I was told at some point. So, I was told that the Circle of the Crone are trying to do some kind of weird, magical, whatever you want to call it, bullshit ritual or whatever. And you know me, I don't really know anything about that stuff. I don't fuck around with any of that. But what I do know is that they wanted a wolf pup. And this is something that I didn't outright tell Mama Lobo. But I did warn her. So I felt a little like, I don't know, we're business partners, right? So thought I would maybe inform you about it a little bit. But
I appreciate the tip.
But yeah. I don't know if they've gotten any yet. I don't know any of that other kind of stuff. I just know that the Circle want a wolf pup, and since you guys all hang out together, I know Jason and Lily and Spaz and all them, that would probably be concerning for them, I guess. And although I don't particularly enjoy Lily, I thought I would at least help out Spaz or Jason. By the way, do you have this on speaker, or are you just talking? You're on the phone.
No.
Okay.
Not like normal.
Okay. But yeah, that's all the information I have.
Alrighty. Thank you. I appreciate it very much.
Yeah, no problem. Is there a specific time?
I was just about to ask about that. If you could just drop it off at the trailer again, you know, it could be like while I'm on my way back, and if you don't really want to see each other, we don't have to do that. Or if you do want to see me, you can wait around. Either way, you know, if you could just drop it inside the trailer, my car. My car is like right at the entrance of the reservation. You can just put it in like my back seat.
All right. Let me know if you need anything else.
We'll do.
And then there's a click.
And then I pull the phone from my face, stop the recording, and I just start the car up, and I'm like, well, looks like we gotta make a trip to the reservation.
Wait, why?
Something I ordered is gonna be there. Actually, it'll be waiting on me when I get there. Right, Sid, right.
You told her either she could just drop it off or that, you know, she doesn't have to wait around for you guys.
Okay. I want to be there to get that as quick as possible. Okay. I gotta go grab something, Lily. Reservation. I don't really. You'll see. You'll see when we get there. I think it's best if we just go. Okay.
I mean, is everything all right? Like.
Yeah, everything's good. Hate them puts on the shit even grin and gives a big thumbs up to the back seats. Everybody can see. He's like, all right, somebody throw in some music so we can at least jam on this ride back. And no more fucking Taylor Swift.
What's wrong with Taylor Swift?
Okay.
She's bad.
What do you mean she's bad? I like Taylor
bad
Swift.
Bad music.
What about Katy Perry?
Okay, I can rock with some Katy Perry.
Yeah, Katy Perry roars fun.
Okay. Oh my god. Okay. So, you all start to head back towards the reservation. Start the car, all that stuff. Everybody's all buckled in. The actual car's a little low because Blanco's in the car too. And yeah, and y'all hate them from what you can hear. Spaz is over there shuffling again with the music and stuff like that. And eventually, you start to hear. That is the wrong one. There we go.
Good mess. So I sat there quietly, agreed politely, because I forgot that I had a choice. Oh, let you push me past the breaking point.
Hate them smiling. It's like tapping the wheel on beat while he's driving.
Help me down, but I gotta pay.
Literally, Lily is just sitting there laughing. She's like laughing to herself. Kaden, what is your reaction to all of this nonsense that's going on?
Trying so hard not to laugh.
I got the eye of the tiger.
Like she's starting to turn a little red from trying not to laugh.
It's into the fire, because I'm
is also singing
a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar.
Oh my god!
This part is, you're a little off time for me, so I imagine she's singing it exactly like that. A little too quickly.
Yeah, that is what I picture too. It's so funny. Oh my god. Y'all, I assume that if you guys got nothing, you're just gonna listen to music as we head back to the reservation.
Yes.
The drive is just goofy as fuck. Y'all are vibing to Katy Perry. And because of the time of day at the moment that it is, which I want to assume that it's about either 11...
probably around midnight or 1 a.m.?
Yeah, I was going to say, like, that makes more sense, yeah. You eventually, after a good, like... from the distance that you guys were at, which you guys were literally in Anaheim, comparatively going back to San Fernando Valley. That's a good, like, right now, because of the time, there is no actual, traffic, really. Y'all were able to make it in at least gunning it a little bit. Y'all were able to make it in, like, y'all were able to make it in like 45 minutes. So the time is currently at least like 1:30 a.m. Hey, you pull up to the actual reservation. And as you do, 2 seconds. Let me check something. I gotta make a playlist for this entire campaign. It's great. where is the thing? Where is my Discord? I need to roll something. You know what? As you pull up, Haytham, mm-hmm. you are able to see that next to your specific car, there's another car, which I forgot what the car was, the car make and model for Quinn's car, but I remember it being white for some weird reason. You see a white-ass car right next to... yours.
Next to my white ass car that's yes. fucked up. Okay.
Yeah. There's one that's not fucked up and there's one that's fucked up. Yours is fucked up. just so you know.
I was wrong. Shit. Okay. Everybody, just stay in the car for just a few moments.
Does any of us recognize the car?
Yes, actually. I don't think Caden would. Actually... Spaz, you would. I don't think Caden would.
Okay.
So, Spaz, you recognize
that car? Why not? I don't think I've ever met them.
That's why. So, Spaz, you recognize Quinn's car. Obviously, you recognize Haytham's beaten up ass car.
Willie.
I hear y'all back there whispering. No, not right now. I know exactly what kind of bullshit will start if y'all have out the car. So just give me...
Why is she here?
It's just
Lily.
We use her.
Jesus.
Please, I'm begging you.
And Quinn's here.
I'm not happy that Quinn's here, jackass. Well, I mean, yes, but not like that.
Caden, that sure. car is... You've never met Quinn. Quinn was one of the other kindred that was... hanging around. She's kind of a bitch, if I'm honest.
You're not wrong. But I just, y'all just do me a favor. Stay in the car. Just give me enough time. Just let me do this real quick, okay?
Okay, if you do this, Haytham, you need to explain what the fuck is going on.
I will. Just let me finish. First, I honestly thought she was just dropping off, but just let me do this. Y'all just sit in the car and let me handle this real quick. And then before I can hear any complaints, I like hop out, close the door behind me, and sort of like pushes his hair back, and he's just like, okay. And he goes up to Quinn's car.
So, before we go to Quinn and Haytham real quick. Lily sits there for a moment. she kind of balls up her fist a little bit. There's a frustrated expression on her face. It can't be that, can it? Spaz, like, I
mean, it could be. Because think about it, he got really happy, and now Quinn's here.
Oh my gosh.
But I thought there Blanco and Quinn were a thing.
I thought so too. But now it's hard to tell.
Kaden, by the way, you can hear all this little conversation.
Blanco already confirmed that nothing happened. He was just locked in the trunk and he busted out.
That is true. I don't know.
You know, I ship it.
Don't kiss real people. That goes out poorly.
No, this is Kay, strictly in character.
This in character, strictly, yeah. I was like,
yeah, that's what he says. That's what he says.
Oh. Wait. He's got another, what was it, Jessica? He's got Jessica. Yeah, I think that's, I don't know. You know, Vanessa, she's been really, they've been hanging out a lot. There's a sudden realization on Lily's face. Wait a minute. So, would it be him messing around with Quinn, and then messing around with Jessica, and then messing around with Vanessa? Is that what it is?
Oh my god. Yeah.
Is he just gonna try to create some kind of harem? Lily, don't let him take you.
What? What? What do you mean?
I don't think he's trying to do that. I think he's just being a whore.
But I'm just gonna look at Kaden, just totally wide-eyed and like in shock. What?
I mean, true. You right, Kaden? You right?
Because as far as we're aware, the girls don't know about each other.
That's awful.
Right?
Why are everybody worried about what Hatham's gonna go tell?
You know, I would hate to be Hatham. That seems like too much work.
Yeah.
But imagine having all these... There's a pause for a moment. Never mind. Anyway, that wasn't even my point. My point was, why the hell is Quinn here? There's something he's not telling us, and it's really concerning me. And if he doesn't tell us, I'm going to do something.
Is there anything else you guys want to say before I...
No.
I feel like a stressed out father. Oh, God.
What about you, Spaz? You got any more input?
I have nothing else for this.
Okay. So, that being said, we're going to hop back up over to Hatham. Hatham, as you get out of the car and you make your way, and you feel a slight disturbance in the force, but you keep making your way to Quinn's car.
You're talking about me flirting. What is going on here?
As you're walking up to the car, or the cars, you see that there is Quinn carrying what looks to be a box. And when you walk, well, she walks up to your car and pretty much tries to open the passenger seat. Thank you for the follow. But she walks up to the seat, or to the passenger, not passenger, the back seat, opens the door, puts the actual, like, box into the car. She hasn't noticed you yet.
She seems too focused.
I'm just sort of standing behind her, just sort of watching, arms crossed.
As she pretty much is able to get the stuff into the back seat, she turns to close, like, to close the door and stuff, and as that happens, she makes eye contact with you. Shit! Is there a reason you're standing behind me?
Oh, I was just letting you finish.
Well, what happened? What do you need?
Oh, nothing. Just, you know, seeing how it was going for you. You doing good?
I mean, it's going as good as it always is. Let's just say I have a lot more to deal with than I would probably like. But, you know, maybe a little good karma for helping you will help.
Yeah, you might need it. But, thank you for the smooth purchase. I appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem. Like I said, I was just gonna drop off the stuff. So, what was it that you asked for again, Haytham?
It was like 4 pistols, silencers, and like ammunition for them. And I didn't do the clip of silver bullets. I did not do that.
I thought you did. Oh no, you didn't.
Okay. I didn't. I decided against it.
Well, everything should be in there. If there's anything missing, we had a bunch. See, the shotgun thing was a little rough, but everything else should be in there. At least that's what Gage told me.
Okay.
But yeah, if you need anything else, just let me know. If you wanna, did you already send me the money or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Since then, I'll wire transfer it to you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then I guess have fun. And then you see that she pretty much ends up walking back to her car. Okay. She gets in, starts the car, pulls the fuck out, and starts to pretty much head out. Spaz, Caden, you guys can see all of this transaction going on. And you're left with nothing but the fact that she is just left now.
Alright, so, after that has happened, I sort of, like, grab the box and, like, I wave them down and, like, point towards my trailer, and I start to, like, walk over there.
What do you think's in the box? I don't know. I mean, unless he's trying to kill us, I mean, guns? Maybe? Wait. No, that would be stupid. That would be really stupid. He wouldn't just do this right in front of us and then try to kill us right as we get into the trailer, right?
I thought he's trying to point us to say he's taking it to the trailer. He told us to stay here.
So are we just gonna wait here?
Knowing that the combined brain cells between them aren't enough
there
to
are none.
That they can't quite comprehend what he meant. And knowing that Caden is just staring like a goo goo doll in the back seat. Haytham pulls his phone out of his pocket and then he calls Spaz. And while he's looking at the car, watching them whisper back and forth.
He's staring at us, right?
Spaz again, check her phone.
But did he say anything?
Ring.
I think it's ringing. Oh my god, he's calling me. Okay. Spaz is gonna answer it. Haytham?
Sorry, y'all just not gonna come inside now that I flagged you down.
I thought you were taking the box to somewhere.
I'm bringing inside the trailer, but of course, you know, I mean, if y'all want answers as to what was going on, what's in the box,
also, I'm so
and why
sorry.
She was here.
I'm so sorry. I saw you guys breaking up there, and she drove off and didn't even like give you a hug goodbye. That's so awful.
We were never together, Spaz.
I mean, for sure your like flirting needs a little bit of work, but
No, like I've never had any romantic interest in that woman. Not even once. Seems more like Blanco in her head thing, funny enough.
Okay, alright, we'll go to your trailer then.
Yeah, okay, I'll meet Joey up whenever y'all get in here.
Wait, so he's actually gonna kill us?
Oh my fucking god.
You know what? Why don't you?
I hate them fucking walks. This is just continues walking towards the trailer.
Wait, are you talking about like that movie? Wasn't there a movie where there's a box and like they were gonna use a box or something to kill someone, right?
Well, I don't know if he
like
has...
what's in the box?
I don't know. Well, all I'm saying is that, you know what? Let's just go figure out what he's doing. Come on, Kaden. And then freaking Lily gets out of the car.
Also, real quick, completely out of character, I just got these body paints, and they smell weirdly like watermelon.
Cool.
Macaroni, Nick.
What? What?
I just wanted to share that information because it surprised me when I first opened it.
Damn.
A little kerfluffle.
Kerfluffle. Anyway. So, I assume that Lily hopped out and is leading the way at this point. So.
Yep.
Okay.
I follow.
Eventually, y'all make your way into the trailer. Haytham, where are you? What are you doing?
I am now sitting in the living room, my box propped open. I am currently, and funny enough, as soon as they come in, I just put the clip in, and I literally just pulled the slide back on the gun.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
And I'm sitting very nonchalantly on the couch with the open box right beside me.
2 seconds, I'm gonna roll something real quick. Oh my
Aiden
god.
Hides behind Lily.
2 seconds. Two seconds. Where is Lily's character sheet? Why don't I have this open?
Who is Lily going to fucking maul me?
Yes.
Bork.
Literally, it's gonna be a bork. Bork.
You just hear like start barking like a puppy and just run by as fast.
Shut up. Nah. So
no, that'd be
much,
Kaden.
Yeah. Damn. Roll.
By the way, for people who are just joining into the stream, Caden's a vampire, not a werewolf.
Yeah.
Nah, that's a dog.
But canonically, he's vampire dog.
No.
Vampire dog. What is that? That's gonna be 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 5? Okay. Also, Spaz, what is your reaction to that?
Spaz is just gonna be like, kind of on guard, I guess. Like, what the fuck?
So, although Lily is very much not, like, she you can tell she looks a little concerned, but she's able to compose herself a little. What are you doing?
Nothing. I just bought these from Coin, and I'm just loading them while I'm up. Why? You seen a ghost or some shit? You're fucking acting like I'm gonna shoot you or something. Stop.
I mean, you wouldn't feel that way if somebody was like, "Hey, I'll explain to you later," and then all of a sudden they go into a trailer, or a building, or whatever, with a box. You walk in thinking that it's really not that big of a deal, and then all of a sudden you see somebody cocking a gun. You're not gonna be a little concerned?
No, because we've been hanging out together for 2 weeks and have been in multiple life or death situations.
Well, then I guess
it
it's
seems
just
like
me.
I'm the only rational. Yeah, I think I'm the only rational one around here nowadays.
What do you mean the only rational one around here? I'm thinking about myself and
Lily,
thinking.
When
and
have
Spaz.
I ever outwardly done anything to even show any sign of aggression towards you or Spaz?
Just because you haven't shown it yet doesn't mean you can't.
Ooh, so now I'm the big bad wolf and you're just waiting for me to huff and puff and blow everything down.
No, hey, I'm not. Hey,
the shit in the grin.
Look, I'm just not stupid either.
I mean, I don't know. I guess I'm just a little bit more trusting of the people, you know, while, you know, lay my head down beside here, you know, per se. You know what I mean? I sleep on the same reservation as you. You know where I stay. At any point, you know, if you really wanted to kill me, you could just open the blinds while I'm sleeping. You know where I stay.
Look, I'm just concerned about Spaz and myself.
But I've never done anything, and I've actually, you know, stuck my neck out for both of y'all.
Spaz is gonna look at Hatham. Hatham, what are you doing? Get that clip out of there. You have to clean it first.
Fine. And then he ejects the clip, pulls the slide so the bullet pops out, catches it, and then tosses the empty gun towards Spaz.
Do you have a towel or something?
I don't know. Make a makeshift
thing to clean this.
But that one's for you. Lily, are you good with guns?
I've never...
Better question. I know you get a little skittish when things start to go sideways, so do you think you'll be able to pull the trigger whenever the time becomes necessary?
There's a pause for a moment from her, and she kind of stares off. Yes?
Hatham looks at her. He can see, like, he can very clearly see the doubt because he knows, like, he knows from past experiences.
If somebody was to hurt Spaz, I would do that.
But no, let's say Spaz isn't there and they pull a gun on you.
Well, yeah, I don't want to die.
I know you don't want to die, but fear is very powerful. That night in the haunted house, you could have died. And you froze up. So this isn't me judging you.
Look,
this is
it's not my
sure
fault.
You're ready.
Look, just there's a tinge of frustration in her. Look, I know that back at the mansion or whatever, I was being fucked with ghosts. You don't understand what I had to see and what I fucking experienced, okay? Just because
Lily,
I get scared or a little bit scared or whatever,
Lily,
doesn't mean I can't protect myself or other people.
Lily, calm down. I'm not getting onto you, and I'm not challenging you. I'm not saying that you're not capable. I'm asking you a question like an adult. And, I mean, if this is a dick swinging contest, I had an evil shadow version of myself throw me into an endless nothing and, you know, torment me with my past life. So,
yes,
I mean,
but
that.
I saw things. I saw things that I probably shouldn't have.
I understand that, Lily. I was just asking a question. It's a question that had to be asked.
Look, I'm not as weak as you all think I am.
I don't think you're weak. I have to know that if I give you this, that you'll be ready to pull the trigger when the time is necessary. Because when you keep one of these on you, you become a part of a lifestyle. If you live by this, you will die by this.
At this point, Lily doesn't even say anything and instead walks up to you, Hatham, with, like, the box. Shreyab just grabs a gun. And looks...
Hatham just
looks at you. Just looks at you, grabs the gun. Doesn't even grab the clip, mind you, just grabs the gun. And then, pretty much, she doesn't really have anywhere... Just kind of sticks it in her pocket.
I toss her. Well, no, I don't even toss her. I just sort of raise my eyebrows, hand her one of the clips on the side and like a box of bullets. I'm like, well, I think you're going to need this if you're going to hold that on you. And then he just smiles.
Huh. Funny. And then she grabs the little ammo cartridge thing. And also sticks it in the other side, her other pocket.
Oh, I forgot. You too. And then I take two of the silencers and I throw them at Spaz and Lily. You catch it, Spaz?
I think so. I hope so. I don't know.
Do you want to roll to try to catch it?
I want Spaz to roll to try to catch it.
Okay. Dex, composure. So, I forgot what the stats were for pistols. I'm gonna have to send you all that. I'll just Google it real quick. Tell me what your successes are.
That was one success.
Okay. So, Spez, as he throws the gun towards you, or the gun, as he throws the silencer towards you, even though you're busy, like, cleaning the gun, you were able to quickly grab it from out of the air, seeing it from the corner of your eye. Lily, on the other hand, she fumbles a little bit, but she was able to catch it.
Alright, and that leaves two of these. One for me, and then one for somebody else. And then, Haytham just closes the box so he can just handle that later. Well, it seems like we have...
What about Kaden?
Yeah.
I look at Kaden. And as you know, I'm still sitting on the couch. I haven't moved. He throws his leg up on top of his other leg, you know, sort of like a dad sitting inside of his studio or whatever, you know. And he crosses his arms. He looks at Kaden. He's like, Kaden, have you ever held a gun in your life?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
You shot a gun.
Yeah.
Is Kaden lying?
No.
Oh, shit. We got a Billy Badass over here. So, what kind of experience do you got, kid?
My dad took me out to the range when I was, like, 12.
Okay.
I know how to take a clip out. That's about it.
Okay, that's what I was looking for. Yeah, no, you know, maybe one of these days I'll take you around back and show you how to shoot. You know, it'll be a nice change of pace. You know, a nice change of pace from wanting to strangle you with both my hands. How do the ghouls feel about this? Are they just sitting in the living room just watching all this unfold?
They are minding their business. They're vibing amongst each other. Just
at this point, they know.
Yeah.
They fucking know. They're just like, yeah, well, when Atham comes home, he's just all business.
Yep.
What are the rest of our members doing? I would assume Guy and Jason went to their respective trailers.
Pretty much. Jason, after you guys had parked, he didn't even say anything. He was just struggling to try to get himself back to normal. And eventually just went back to, like, go rest and stuff. Guy, on the other hand, he pretty much followed you guys inside. He's kind of watching this kind of unfold. I've got a gun, so don't worry. And I've got this. And he pulls out the machete.
Ah, the infamous machete.
So, I'm good. But, I have some stuff to take care of. So, just let me know if you guys need anything.
Alright, that's perfect.
And with that, he pretty much walks out of the trailer.
So it seems as if all of our business has concluded for the night. I mean, I'm not kicking y'all out. Y'all can hang out here as much as I want. Y'all know that.
Wait a minute. Before you even start
happened? Actually, this is, you know, good thing you said that, because my mind is scattered in 30,000 places, but,
I mean, besides the deal, right? Really, that wasn't the only reason she came, right?
Yeah, no, that is not. It's, well, actually, yes, that's the only reason she came, but that's not the only thing we talked about. I pick up my box, close it, and I throw it under, and I move it out the way. I put it, like, beside the wall, and I look at Spaz and Lily. I go from, you know, my shitting grin to very serious stone face, and I look at both of them, and I say, y'all are gonna need to sit, and when I play this for you, you're gonna have to listen to everything I tell you. No ifs, ands, or buts. You will not act irrationally. You will not go AWOL. Is that understood?
Wait, it's okay if you had a thing with.
Is that under? No, I'm not joking around right now. Is that understood?
Get to your point.
Sit down.
When you say that, there's there's like a, like, who the fuck are you talking to? Look, from Lily.
Hatham's eyes just sort of reflect how stone cold serious he is right now. You can just sort of like see them open up a bit, and like you can sort of see like his muscles like just sort of flexing like in his arms, and he's not fucking around at all.
Whatever. And then Lily just takes a seat on the couch.
After seeing her sit, he untenses a little bit. He looks at Spaz and nods at the seat like right beside her.
I'm concerned. What is this?
Just sit. Okay.
Okay, Spaz is gonna sit down. Very reluctantly, but she's gonna sit down.
Alright, I'm gonna play a recording for you two. This recording is gonna say something, and it's gonna make you feel some type of way. This is without doubt, this is guaranteed. But remember, you will not go off the walls, you will not act on your own. We're gonna do this smart, and we're gonna handle this correctly.
Should I be in the room for this?
Yes, Caden said.
Okay.
I don't even look at Caden. I just tell him to sit. And then Hatham pulls out his phone, and he begins to play the recording of the call. Real quick.
After a while of listening to basically what happened, we all remember what happened, right?
Yeah.
Okay. After hearing Quinn say the words that she is saying and her be so nonchalant and very whatever about everything that's going on, there is.
Wait, no, let me get that song. Let me grab it. Okay, I got it. You're good.
So, as the recording continues to play, slowly but surely, all of you roll a perception. That is...
Can I get an advantage on that? Since
it's an investigation, yes. Give yourself an extra die.
Okay.
Since you know exactly probably what's going to happen.
Oh, fuck yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah! I got 10, 9, 9, 7, 6, 5, 5, 9.
For the love of Christ, Spaz.
Spaz is oblivious as always. Ah.
Oh no! Wait. No, that's pretty good. Pretty good. What were all of your successes? Total.
Mine.
Yes, for all of you.
Oh, I got. On my end. I got 10, 9, 9, and then I got another 9.
Well, you know.
Okay. And Caden got a 7. I mean, got a 10.
And then Spaz, you didn't get any. Spaz, you're too focused on listening to what's going on, so you don't notice this. But Hatham and Caden, you start to slowly see. Well, you start to see that slowly. Lily's fists are clenching, like. she's trying her everything to not lose her shit at the moment.
Hatham slowly walks up to Lily.
2 seconds before you do that.
Oh, God. Okay, yeah. Let's wait to see what you're...
There is a burning rage that can be felt from Lily. Her fists are clenched. She is literally physically shaking at this point. And her head is down as she's listening to this. She fucking knew! She knows! She knew everything! Lily, and she hasn't said anything?
Lily. Calm down. I know you're upset, and I know you're angry. I don't like her just as much as the next person.
This is bullshit. This is complete Lily. Bullshit. Ever since all of you came here, you've done nothing but cause this.
Oh, I've... You know... I know you're angry, so I'm just gonna chalk it up to that. Okay. I get it. You're emotional. You're young. And a lot of things have been
going on. I'm not emotional and I'm not young!
To me, you're young. Let's just say that.
Spaz, what is your reaction to all of this?
This is why I told you to sit. This is why I told you to be logical.
This is bullshit. She knows more than what she's giving off. You know that, right?
Yes. I know a lot, okay? I infer a lot. I'm smart because I think and I wait before I make rash decisions. I get it, you're angry. I don't like her either, but I also know that she's a useful tool, that if we play our cards right, we can get whatever we need out of her. As much as I want to kill her.
How do you know she's not playing you?
That's... Because I know... She doesn't know I know. But I know that she fucked up. She fucked up in the sense of she let it be a little too visible, a little bit too known about her connections with the Chrome. Essentially, she... Hello, guys. Oh, shit.
You need some water. You need some water. Hydrate.
I wish I had it. Come on, please. Give me a drip. Nothing. Nothing at all. But let me pick up that door. Hold on, I need a sip of water, y'all. I can't. My throat is drier than the Sahara fucking desert. Hey, don't move out my way, you old dumb dog.
I'll give everybody
a 5 minute break.
5 minute break. Go pee, go eat something, go whatever. I love drinking hot ass water. It's great. It's great.
It's this is literally perfect time because I got the dogs out anyways.
Yeah. You good? You know, I'm gonna go pee. I shall return.
Have fun.
It's okay, I'll think of you as I pee.
No comment.
Anyway, I'm gonna go pee. I'll be back.
Thank you.
shit.
Welcome back.
You having a good session, Caden?
Yep.
That's good. Sorry I haven't been talking to you as much. I keep trying to bring myself back to, you know, bring you in more. It's my fault.
You're good.
Spaz, you there, bud?
Nope, they're dead.
Oh, no! Spaz died in the war!
I just choked on my string cheese.
What's up with you and choking on string cheese like every other fucking time I'm talking to you? Yes, you do!
No?
Yes, you do!
I mean, I'm eating string cheese, like, every session, but I don't choke on it.
I don't know, it feels like you've choked on string cheese, like, every session.
No. Also, sorry I came in there with the paint comment. It's just really weird.
Is it that good?
Well, it smells like watermelon rind. So I don't know if that's good or bad.
I mean, that sounds nice.
It's like a sour watermelon smell. Like a really watered down sour watermelon.
I like watermelon. Watermelon just tastes so good.
You want to know what my favorite way to eat watermelon is?
What is it?
Cubed, and then you put just a pinch of salt on it.
No!
Yes.
No! Oh yes, it tastes good. I had so much hope for you. I'm disappointed, I'm sorry, but I just can't co-sign that behavior. I can't do it.
Like, what's wrong with that?
You don't put salt on watermelon. You eat your watermelon, you suck the succulent juices from it, you go after you done got fucking watermelon sweet juice everywhere, and then you enjoy it. You don't want salty on your watermelon.
I do. I like salt.
No!
I have an iron deficiency.
No! They need ice!
No, I can't because it hurts my teeth.
Oh!
I have, like, hypersensitive teeth.
Bean,
it sucks.
Why are you doing this to me? How could you do this to me? No, wrong thing. Adventure plate. Boom!
What?
Nothing. Oh, well, I mean, I can tell you because Sydney's not here, but... never mind, she's back. I can't say anything anymore. Welcome back, Squilliam.
Ooh.
I got water and a Pop-Tart. It's crazy. We finished the night tonight. I, okay, so, out of character, but I've been sort of extending it because I didn't know if you wanted me to end the night, and then we pick up and we start the next night tonight, or what? Because we have like a whole ass like, well, now we got like 40 minutes left, but
yeah.
You know, more if everybody wants to go on more, but you know,
there's literally only three
of
us. There's literally only three of us. It's a possibility.
It's up to all of y'all. We could start a night. I don't think we can get into, like, any beef and gravy. You know, maybe, like, get, like, a hook for the next night. So, you know, it doesn't start off with all of us. Well, we all wander back into Halo's trailer. So, what are we doing tonight?
I mean, that's kind of how it goes, doesn't it?
Let me check my phone. Hatham goes to his bat cave again. Let me check my phone in the darkness again. Another one.
You're really not helping your case with Lily. Anyway. Are we all good? Is Spaz back?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll wait for Spaz. I'm vibing.
How do I do a screenshot on my computer again?
I mean, I do it the complicated way, which is like control screen print and then paste it on Paint. I do it the complicated way.
What's the easy way? I just want to like grab this monitor.
I don't know. I should put pepper in this. Fuck. Hold on.
Apple?
Yeah. You never had pepper in a Caesar salad?
Who just actively chooses a Caesar salad over a house salad?
I like Caesar salad. I like house salad.
The only good Caesar salad is Olive Garden salad.
Olive Garden, where we treat you not as shitty.
Pretty shitty, but not as shitty.
Yeah.
Yes. But, yeah.
Go get your pepper real quick.
That's fine. I've got cheese in this shit.
I think the best experience I had in an Olive Garden was we were driving home from a convention. And we were still in cosplay.
That's funny.
So I come in with devil horns, and my friend comes in with gems glued to their face. And then as we were leaving, a group of like 5 or 6 Spider-Men walk in.
That's funny.
Did they do the meme?
No, but a bunch of kids screamed because, oh my god, it's Spider-Man.
Oh my god, it's Stuart Little! Can I have your autograph? Beans, you're too young to know about Stuart Little.
I know about Stuart Little.
No, you don't.
He's Beans. Mouse.
Beans isn't that young.
Stuart Little died in the war.
I mean, they're the baby right here, right now, but like...
He's just a baby!
It's a baby!
It's a baby! Just a baby!
That's how I picture Caden. Just a baby. A baby. Literally. A baby that gets so angy.
Angy.
Angy baby.
Hayden calls some friends over to the house. Hey, yo, guys, check out my new dog. I'm not a... Yeah, I'm still training him right now. He's still acting up a little bit. He's just a baby.
Hello.
Hello.
I have returned.
Oh, hello.
It's ASMR time.
I'm eating a salad. Because I haven't eaten all day.
Nice. Well, not that you've not eaten all day, but they're eating now.
Let me, like, drink something, and then we'll continue the argument. Okay.
Hey, Alex, check your DMs real quick.
I think we're ready. Or at least I'm ready.
I'm ready whenever y'all are.
Yep.
Okay. So, as we were saying.
Listen, Lily, I understand. But that's why you have to remain calm and composed when doing these things. Because if you
so the circle of the crown literally took... Fuck, what was her name?
That phone call.
I forgot her name. Fuck.
The baby.
Julia! Julia!
The baby.
She took they took Julia.
That phone call that I just had was me just finding out. I wouldn't hold that information from you, so calm down.
Well, literally, we saw you answer the phone.
Yeah, I know. Like, how long ago? Like, the car ride over?
So she's known about this.
I guess so.
That fucking bitch.
Now, Lily, this is why I need you to sit, and this is why I need you to listen. I'm gonna handle it.
We have to get her.
We are going to get her. I'm gonna make some calls. I'm gonna talk to Matthias, and I'm gonna see what I can do to help us get her as easy and as safely as possible.
Does anybody know anything about the Circle of the Spaz? Do you know anything about, like, I mean, I guess you really wouldn't, but I don't know. I assume that they do what? What kind of vampires even are they? I just know that they wear weird robes or whatever kind of dress or whatever they were wearing when me and Jason saw them.
The night that me and Jessica and Jason, when we're going to feed, one of the vampires that me and Jason killed was the Circle of the Crone, and the other one who got away was also the Circle of the Crone.
I know, I was there with you guys. Do you not remember?
So, and they use, like, weird blood magic, so I'm gonna assume they're of the occult. So, we have to go about this very carefully.
We need to understand when they're even having this ritual. Because they're not going to kill or whatever, or do whatever they're gonna do until they need to.
Yes, I know. That's why we have to move smartly.
We have to move quickly.
We have to move smartly. If we move too quick, we're going to walk in there and I'll end up slaughtered, or even worse, they're fucking ghoul slaves.
The problem is, Haytham, that's a kid. They have a kid.
I understand that's a child, but if we weren't in there guns blazing, we're going to die. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. If we run in there without a plan and without thinking, we will die, and then that kid is just gonna end up.
We at least need to
anyway.
Know some type of time frame.
I understand that. That's what I'm telling you. But that's why you have to calm down and think rationally, Lily. We have connections now. We
Spaz,
have.
What do you think we should do?
To be able to help us.
You're muted, just so you know, if you're talking.
I mean, we did just do a bunch of stuff for those Invictus guys. I mean, it might be a little early to call in a favor, but...
Listen, I'm going to worry about making the calls and this, that, and the third, alright? That's what I was just saying, like, 20 seconds ago. I'm going to do what I can. I'm going to get what information I can. And I'm going to see what kind of allies I can bring to this. Because if we just run in there and start trying to kill vampires, either A, we die, or B, we succeed, but then we really do start an entire war that'll rain down the full force of multiple covenants on the reservation.
They're going to have a war between the Forsaken and themselves anyway.
Lily, you're not understanding, okay?
Do you understand? Does Mama Lobo even know about this?
I just found out, basically, like, 20, 30 minutes ago, when I made that
phone
call.
But she said something about knowing, about saying something,
I'm
to Mama Lobo, and maybe that's why she was so concerned.
Mama Lobo, okay, Lily, you're not listening. Listen, Lily, if you can't listen, then you're gonna have to stay back while me and Spaz handle this.
Fuck you, no I'm not.
You
have no domain
over
me.
Okay, Lily. You walk in there, you get yourself killed. I don't care. Because you clearly don't care either way.
I do care.
Apparently not, because you won't fucking listen. You're acting like a goddamn child right now. And I need you to act like...
Stop fucking calling me a child!
This is the first time I've called you a goddamn child because you're acting like one right now.
2 seconds. Also, if I'm getting too intense, please tell me.
No, you're good.
2 seconds.
While this is happening, Spaz is gonna put her hand on Lily's shoulder. It's okay. We have to think this through.
Spaz, when you put your hand on her shoulder, the first thing she does is literally push you off.
Ooh.
Very aggressively.
Ah!
I'm tired of fucking taking orders from your stupid ass. I'm done. And you know what? If I'm so fucking stupid, fine. I'll figure this shit out. I don't need anybody to fucking tell me how to do anything or how to even fucking make a fucking rational decision. And
Lily,
with that,
when we walked into that guy,
with that,
Brandon?
The first thing she does is she fucking walks out. She straight up just walks out. And I need to roll something real quick.
Oh, again. Sweet God.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. As she storms out, there is no reaction. There is nothing else that is said. And what you, well, all of you roll a perception. You triggered her, Vajay.
Oh, hey, well,
them, you triggered
her. She needs to fucking hear it.
That's no successes over here.
God damn, I'm going
Son
crazy.
Of a bitch! Son of a bitch, man!
Oh my God, do you see this? Look at this shit, dude!
What the fuck? Oh my God.
Alright, so,
okay,
starting from
so,
the top, I got 10, 10, 9, 10, 10,
you're
7.
Good. You're good. Kaden, what did you get? Was it 2? 2 successes? Spaz, you didn't get any? Oh. So, Spaz, you're more concerned about the fact that Lily just pushed the fuck out of you. Which she's never done that before, ever. From what you can tell, at least, she's extremely heated. Haytham and Kaden, what you all hear as, you know, Lily is out, there is a sound of clothes tearing. And then there's silence.
Haytham. This time, this time the sigh just this is like more like a fucking groan. And he's like, okay, so I might not be the smartest vampire in town, but it sounds like she just turned into a wolf and she just ran away. Spaz, let me call Mama Lobo real quick.
She did what?
Just let's try to get Mama Lobo over here before we all go chasing after, okay? I think
that's
right,
making her way to the door.
Well, there goes another one. I look at Kaden. I say, Kaden, come on. We gotta go talk to Mama Lobo. And I'm like, well, Fargo, I might as well just start packing for an inevitable trip coming soon. And I go over to my box, grab my gun, grab my new shiny gun. I grab a clip, bullets, throw it in the guitar case. Well, I throw the bullets in the guitar case after, you know, throwing a clip into it. Put it in the back of my waistband, and I grab the case. I'm like, come on, we gotta go talk to Mama Lobo. You want a piggyback ride, Kaden? I know you have a little trouble with that little bit of, with that little leg over there. I'm just teasing them at this point.
I'm fine.
All right, then come on, little tink tink, let's go in and hobble on over.
Well, Spaz, as you make your way to the door, you open it, and you see outside, literally, like, not too far away from where the entrance is, there is literally just a shit ton of ripped clothes. Just a lot of ripped clothes. And from what you recognize, they are literally the clothes that Lily was wearing. She literally shifted without even giving a fuck anymore.
That means she dropped her gun.
Yeah.
So, since I'm like, also, like, standing at the door, sort of looking over Spaz's shoulder, I'm like, hey, make sure to pick up that gun. I paid a lot of money for that. And the bullets, too. We'll give it to, like, either, like, I don't know, like, Guy or Jason or something. Just hold on to it for me. You can dual wield it, you know, that'd be cool. But, and then, like, I just sort of, like, gently, like, push Spaz out the way with my finger. Excuse me. I gotta go talk to Mama Lobo.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna go run over there and grab her gun. Whatever stuff she had left behind. And then try to figure out, like, where she went toward.
Okay.
I yell over my shoulder as I'm walking towards Mama Lobo's thing. If you find out anything, text me.
Spaz, I'm gonna need you to roll a perception, and then Haytham and Kaden, you guys make your way over to Mama Lobo's trailer. The trailer that you guys have been to probably way too much at this point, besides the fact that you guys always had to Haytham's trailer, but but sitting outside
flabbergasted.
Sitting outside the trailer, sitting where she normally sits, is Mama Lobo. Her little stool, chair thing, where she normally sits on her little porch. There's a slight breeze in the air, and little wind chimes and other things she had hanging up they're swaying in the dark night. Mama Lobo sits there with a very... She seems to be staring off. Almost as if she's in a meditative state or, like, a trance kind of state at the moment. Doesn't really seem like she's very much paying attention to reality at the moment. But she is sitting there.
That was my
suitcase,
by the way.
Spaz, you can definitely see footprints. You literally see paw prints heading off in pretty much out. At least from what you can see from here, it's towards, like, the outside of the actual, like, reservation itself. And sort of towards where the forests kind of are. At least from what you can tell, she didn't go off into the street to go run somewhere in the city. She went towards the forest area. Why? But that's what she's, I guess, chosen to do. Are you following the trail?
I will be following the trail.
Sounds like an annoyed significant other when their partner gets drunk and they just, like, run off and go do dumb shit. Here we go again.
Anyway, as you make your way, following the footprints. And it is kind of dark. Sorry, give me 2 seconds.
Uh-oh, it's Mother Dearest.
Okay. As I was saying. Spaz, you make your way towards the direction of which Lily went to. It is somewhat dark. And as you go deeper into the forest, it's getting a little bit more darker. And at this point, it's getting a little bit hard to actually see anything, honestly. but what you do hear is you hear growling eventually. You hear what sounds like branches and like pieces of wood snapping. There is almost like the sound of somebody or something beating a tree. And then there is a silence for a moment. And then as you approach the sound, rather than the growling and aggression and all that, it eventually turns into what sounds like crying. There's soft crying that is coming from between the trees and the darkness.
Lily?
That does not fit! I'm sorry! Wait, that's not
the
right one.
We're not letting that slide.
There we go. That's the right one. Anyway. There's no response, Spaz. There's just crying.
Can I go toward the crying?
As you approach, your eyes start to adjust to the darkness, right? This is also not the correct one. This one. That's what it is. Sorry. There is, from what you can see as you approach, there is literally, you can see the lightly, at least what you can kind of tell, light-skinned individual. Pretty much on the floor.
Oh, so she light-skinned now?
Gang. She's, like, slightly light-skinned. She has a little bit of tan skin. That's not the point. Anyway.
Oh, so she a nigga? Like me?
Why are you ruining this moment, dude? She... You see Lily pretty much on the ground, just, like, just, like, she's crying, and it's almost as if she's still kind of in the position that she was in when she was shifted before, but at this point, she's bare naked at this point. And she gets on her knees and just sits back and continues to cry to herself as she holds herself.
You know, Spaz is going to get her clothes out from earlier because she's still wearing the plague doctor outfit. And she's going to, like, throw the sweater at Lily. You're going to catch a cold if you sit out here like that.
When when you say that, there's almost like a flinch. And then when you throw the sweater at her, she also, like, through her tears, she sees it, and then looks to you. Then you see nothing but her tear-stained face, her sad eyes. Although the moon isn't full tonight, there's definitely, like, somewhat of a light because of it. And in this moment, roll a intelligence composure, Spaz. You know what, I'll give you an extra dice, please, for the love of Christ. I'll give you an advantage.
So reroll.
Yeah, just reroll, fuck it. I'll give you an advantage, because this is something that you should know, or would know, Spaz would know, I don't know. Okay. And so, as you make eye contact with her, there's this weird thought. Even with her looking like a hot mess and just also being, like, sobbing and all that, something pops into your mind. Although you've always had... Lily has always been the one that's either tried to at least be brave or try and be tough or whatever. She's always had this, in a sense, this sort of personality where she isn't scared of anything. And so a lot of the time, even though you can kind of tell that, or you would know, that she doesn't always feel tough or aggressive or anything like that. She's never exactly looked vulnerable either. The only time you've ever seen this sort of or felt this kind of vulnerability is when she showed you the area where people carve out special dates. That is the one and only time you've ever seen this sort of vulnerability from her. Well, until now. And at this point, she takes the sweater that you've thrown at her and what she does is instead she just, if anything, she just hugs it. Almost covering herself, but also just, like, as a reaction. What do you do?
Spaz is gonna sit next to Lily.
Mm-hmm.
And just put her arm around her. And just sit there quietly.
So, as you do that, Spaz, Lily pretty much ends up she's, like, looking down at this point, like, almost, like, ashamed in a sense. And then, feeling your arm around her, she ends up pretty much... She ends up looking up or looking at you. and then she pretty much ends up grabbing onto you and hugging as tightly as she can. And she's, like, basically buried her face kind of in your side chest kind of area. And, again, you start to hear the sobbing, the soft sobbing from her.
Hey, Lily, where do you think your tree is?
There's a pause for a second, and then she kind of moves her head away from you. Like, the tree? The tree? I don't know. It's dark out here. I mean, I... I'm sorry that I pushed you, and I'm sorry I'm such a child.
You're not a child. I think what Haytham was just trying to explain is that we need to do this as a group. We can't take them on by ourselves. And you know, this is why I said I should have peed on my tree, because I'd be able to sniff it out.
Oh my god. Can't. I'm laughing genuinely, but then also there Lily looks at you, Spaz, which is like she's like still sniffly and all that, but she starts to laugh as you say that. I guess you have a point, but... why are you so weird? And with that, she she places her hand on your head. Why are you so weird? Honestly, you come up with the weirdest things.
I mean, just because I wanted to pee on the tree doesn't mean I need head pads. I'm not a dog, Lily. I'm not Caden.
I mean, would you rather me? I mean, I could go. I can go and. You know what? No, I don't want to. Boys are gross. Honestly, Spaz, I was going to go and do something alone, honestly. But I was afraid. And a lot of the time, I am afraid of, you know, stuff happening to us, to my family, to, you know, everybody else in the reservation. And it... Spaz, when I was in... When we were in that the haunted house, mansion, whatever. I saw things. I saw things, and I think I might have had an experience in the spirit realm. I don't know. I don't know if it was the spirits trying to give me something or whatever, but I saw things, and it scares me. A lot of this scares me, honestly. And I think when it comes to a lot of the stuff that's going on, it's at some point things are gonna get really bad, and I don't know what to do about it. And I don't know how else to explain it but that. And I know you're more knowledgeable about all that, but it's just it's scary. And I don't really want anything to happen to you or anybody else. If that makes sense. I don't know. I didn't even tell. I mean, I told a little bit to Mama Lobo about it. And like, when I came back early, and it was because I got scared. And I don't want anything to happen to you. Like, even with hanging out with the Blood Talons or whatever, it scares me. I mean, realistically, they scare me, but that's not the point. Anyway, I'm just rambling. And then you see that she pretty much takes the sweater and kind of just slides it over, you know. Thank you. I'm sorry if I freaked you out or whatever.
Bess is just gonna head pet Lily.
You know what? Why don't you do a perception roll?
Perception time. Yo, that was one success.
From what you can see, Spez, there's, even though it's somewhat dark, there's like a slight tinge of blush that is on her face. And also, at this point, she's just kind of looking away. I don't have bottoms, so I don't know how we're going to get back.
You know, I didn't think this through. Wait, okay, quick OOC. So is the Plague Doctor outfit like a robe, or is it just like tops and bottoms?
I would say, well, I mean, think of like a doctor's outfit, right? So, I mean, I guess they would have like bottoms too, so I would assume.
Okay. So then if that's the case, then all right. Okay. Spaz is gonna hand Lily her pants.
Bit!
The ones she's not wearing.
Oh, really? I wouldn't have guessed. Thank you. And then you see that she starts to, like, put on the pants. And then she stands up.
Spaz's gonna be looking in the corner, kind of blushing.
Okay. Get 2 seconds. I'm gonna do something, because my brain is not... Also, I know we're going a little over. I'm sorry. We're almost done. I promise. We'll go back to Haytham and Hayden in a second. I promise.
I know I'm enjoying the gate. The cute game.
Right? There is an awkward silence for a moment, Spaz. And you can assume that, you know, Lily also feels that because of the tension that's in the air. And although she's looking to the side, eventually you feel a tug on your arm.
Spaz is gonna look over. Are you done?
At this point, Spaz, you make like straight up eye contact with her, and that being said, she stares at you for a moment, and then she leans in and straight up just kisses you.
Spaz is gonna lean into it for a second. And then realize something. We gotta go talk to Mama Lobo. I totally forgot we're supposed to meet up with them.
When you say that, Spaz, there is a complete oh my gosh. There is... She Spaz, she opens her eyes and then just looks at you. And then... there's, again, this awkward and... complete red on her face, and at this point she gets awkward and then totally backs away.
We need to go. Let's just go.
And then she lets go of your arm, Spaz, and then she starts walking the complete opposite direction, just trying to get out of this at this point.
Lily, wait. Spaz is gonna run after.
At this point, she's just walking.
Okay, we'll walk after her very quickly. Lily, look at me.
What? What?
And Spaz is gonna lean in and give her a kiss back.
When you do that, Spaz, there is, like, a shocked expression on her face, and then she kisses back. Anyway, once you two finish, Lily pulls back. And then, again, there's still that little shade of blush on her face. And this time, she grabs your hand. We should probably go.
Oh my god, the gay besties are coming out!
This is a win.
Yeah, we have to go find that pup. Mama Lobo would know what to do.
Yeah. And then she pretty much starts to drag you along, Spaz. But that being said, is there anything else you would like to say or do before I go to hate them and Kate?
I have.
How do we explain to Mama Lobo that you don't have a bra?
Spaz, why are you like this? We don't have to worry about that right now. It's fine. Anyway. And she continues to drag you along. Anyway, what were you going to say, Haytham?
I have a specific song request for when it switches back over to me and Kaden.
Okay.
So, you know the shop music from Legend of Zelda? I think it's Twilight Princess. I don't know the name of it off the top of my head. I fucking... Wait. No, I don't... Wait, it might not be from Twilight Princess, but it's like that. It's that funky music. That do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I want it to be, like, the complete opposite of, like, whatever the hell was going on between the lists.
I mean,
It's the funky music where they're dancing.
The funky music when they're dancing.
Yeah, give me something funky and goofy. It's gonna immediately switch whenever we tell Mama Lobo what the fuck I'm about to tell her, but at least for a few moments, we stroll over.
2 seconds. Funky? I can give you funky.
Let me down a fat track.
it probably... That is not what I wanted! That's not what I wanted! Oh my fucking god, dude!
So as me and Kaden are walking over, you know, I just sort of look at him. I'm like, hey, you know, you're not that bad for a dog.
To keep on walking.
You know, I should give you another Pop-Tart and see what happens. No, nothing. You're not entertaining any of my tomfoolery now that we made it back. No. Hold up! Damn.
That is not. No, I was gonna say this is better.
When Mother Was There is a banger.
Anyway. Continue.
You know, Kate, you're starting to grow into me. That little display of you know, for still standing up for yourself back at the pound. That was in some inspirational shit. I mean, yeah, I almost knocked your cane out of your hand and choked the shit out of you right there in front of everybody. But I can respect somebody standing up for the good shit.
He's just gonna look at you like, what the fuck, dude?
Haytham has on his shit-eating grin. You know, if you ever need a place to sleep, my trailer is open to you, friend. But if I catch you in my room, I'll strangle you. Let's go ahead and get over to Mama Lobo. Oof. Oh, Jesus Christ. By the way, things are probably gonna get very serious very quickly. Let's just enjoy this moment of peace as we walk over. The calm before the storm, as they say. Hey, is that you playing that funky music in the background, Kate? Yo, that's some tight shit. You don't hear that?
What?
Hatham turns around to look at the audience. This guy. And then continues to talk to Kane. Yeah, you know, this music. You know, you can't hear it. This shit is just a jam. It's a pop.
Hayden's gonna try and walk a little bit faster.
Hobble faster!
Hatham takes a moderate jog and then just gaps. He just gaps Caden. Like, remember, I can move 3 times faster than you can, tortoise.
As Caden hobbles very quickly to Mama Loba, and you follow right next to him, Hatham. Eventually, you two make your way up to Mama Lobo. And she, again, this time her eyes are closed. And she is almost like she's meditating.
I clear my throat and I hate them. This sigh is like a I feel bad sigh. And he, like, gently sits down in front of Mama Lobo. And, like, he, like, uses his head to motion for Caden to also sit down beside him.
Caden
right.
Sits down.
I, like, very gently say, Mama Lobo.
¿Qué quieres, mijo?
I don't speak Spanish, but I'm gonna assume that you probably asked me what's wrong. I have some information that you're not gonna like, but you're simultaneously gonna be glad that I have. And I mean, I know you're a lot more rational woman, but just so you know, I told the same thing to Lily and Spaz, and Lily took off into the woods, transformed into a wolf. Spaz went after her though. So, we have a lead on the pup.
With that being said, she opens her eyes, and then she looks to you two. Do you know where she is?
Possibly, if this information is true. It's a start, if this is true. And I'm like, so... I know you're a rational woman, Mama Lobo, but I also know that such a tender situation like this can make somebody go from 0 to 100 very quickly. So I just ask that you just remain calm and trust that, you know, I want to do my best to find her. But I'm going to play a recording for you. This is from roughly like 45 minutes, maybe an hour ago when I made a phone call. And then I pull out my phone, I set it on the table, I put it on speaker, and I play the recording for her.
She listens carefully. And as it continues, she sits and... It's almost as if the cogs are kind of turning in her head, in a sense. And eventually, she says, "That's enough. That... Hi, Mother Wolf. So,
It is Kindred that have her. She is correct, though. She did tell me a queen, correct?
Yeah.
She told me that the Circle of the Crone were looking for a pup. I just, I didn't have proof. I only had the word of mouth. I still don't have proof, nor do any of you. But if they have her, as she said they probably do, the rest of the pack is not going to be happy about it. Not to mention, we have the Pure who are nearby as well. We thought it might have been them. We wanted to give the Kindred the benefit of the doubt.
I can understand why everybody would, of course, be upset. Very understandable, so. But I know we have to move very, very smartly. You know, we have to plot our moves and use our resources as to not turn this into a full-scale war. And, yeah, Lily, she needs to get her head on the straight, because she took off like she was willing to go do something, but there's nothing much she can quite do right now. Like I said, Spaz went to look for.
Lily is very protective of all the pups. And everybody here in the reservation. She's always been. It's understandable that would anger her.
I know. And I agree. It makes me angry that they would even think about taking the child. I don't know these people, but that's horrible. And I understand why she's upset.
To think of the things that they could possibly be planning. I don't know anything about their rituals. But I do know blood magic. I know some of the gods that they deal with and worship, and the only reason why I know of this is because of some of their gods and such intertwine with ours, which is hard to understand, but it's true.
That's interesting.
There is, what is the date today?
I'll pick my phone back up and I'll just tap my screen so I can see the date, then I tell it to her.
Currently, from what you check from your phone, it is the 15th?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wrote it down.
Thank you. But it is the 15th. And that being said, again, the music is too intense, and it's not what I'm trying to do.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Lucky.
I'm trying. I'm like, over
Lucky.
It.
The Persona music was perfect, because in-game, it's like, that music can be used for like a sort of serious conversation or the most casual conversation. That was perfect for me, at least, but that's because I like Persona.
Whatever. This or Beneath the Mask? Yeah, we'll just do that.
Meh.
Okay.
Yeah, Beneath the Mask, yes.
So, that being said, you see that Mama Lobo thinks for a second. What I understand from the Circle of the Crone, they believe in many different gods and goddesses, but they specifically, there is one god in particular, from what I know. I believe it's a goddess. And you see that she thinks for a moment.
There is. What is their name again? I wrote it down and I can't find it. The goddess of the moon. There is. Oops. They have. They do believe in the spirit realm just like we do. And it does exist, and they do have access to that as well. It's a lot more complicated. But it is something. And. They have another goddess. That is. Morrigan. And they have another, which I can't remember, but those are at least some that I know of. And they do have celebrations constantly about whenever it's a specific moon, and sometimes even a. Sacrifice. Sacrifices, they have celebrations, they have sometimes both. They even, from what I've heard and been told, they even give birth sometimes, which isn't a normal thing for kindred to do.
It is not. That is correct.
I've been told that the creatures that they birth are not even kindred themselves. It's almost like a, what is the word? You see that she's trying to figure out the correct word, but they're as what you would call homunculi. I don't know if you know what that is, but they are not creatures that are normal. But whenever they do sacrifices for their gods and goddesses, they're doing it for a specific purpose. There is a legend, from what I've been told, that there is a god or some kind of, think of like the Christianity, correct? There was a savior that was conceived, apparently a messiah, something like that. Jesus. Jesus.
Yes.
There is something that is supposed to be conceived according to legends, from what I've been told. Is it good or bad? I don't know. But I don't know if that takes a sacrifice. I don't know if it has anything to do with Julia. I don't know everything, but that's of what I understand and know. We need to get Julia back.
We will.
She... I don't know if... I don't know if the girls told you, but she is the youngest one, the youngest pup we have here. She is not but a niña. A little girl.
Don't worry, if there's one thing I hate more than anything, the sick fucks who decide to bring children into any equation. So don't worry. We will get her back. No matter what.
And for Lily, I need you all to understand that Lily is a little... She can be a little rash. But she does it because she cares. And also... She's been through a lot more than I think most of you know. I don't even know if Cassandra knows.
Can you imagine? I just need... I'm worried about her. Because every time we get into any peculiar situation, she freezes. And that could either lead to her death or somebody else's death. So I need her to be ready for this. Because I can do everything within my power to protect her. But at the end of the day, there's going to come a point in time where she has to be ready to protect herself. Because if she freezes, then that's it.
I hate them. Sometimes... I mean, we all are fearful.
Of course.
And she is still young. She will learn with time. But... I know for a fact that she will not let anything happen to others. From what I know. Not after if you must know, she lost a sibling. And it was due to her not... She froze. Something had happened, and... It was a complicated thing. Even her family wasn't happy, obviously. I know that she carries that guilt and burden on her shoulders. She wants to protect others, and she wants to be there for others. She just doesn't... Like I said, she's young. And she's still dealing with that loss. I would say, my thought is either teach her or have someone else teach her.
Alright. I think good old Hatham can teach her a few tricks here and there. Puts on a shit-eating grin. And he smiles at Mama Loba and he says, "Don't worry, I'm gonna get everything back to normal. Well, the closest semblance of normal that a vampire and a group of werewolves can really have."
See, I know that the spirits are watching all of you,
right now. And they are guiding you. Whether it feels like it or not. Cassandra has a spirit with her. Constantly. Even when I found her, I sensed something different with her. But you all need to protect each other, regardless.
Of course.
And you, my child, she looks over to you, Caden. I know this world is a lot different than what you're used to. But from what I know, and from what the spirits have at least offered in terms of thoughts or advice, there's a reason you're here. And there's gonna be great things that come from you. Just don't be afraid to speak your mind or act. Sometimes acting is a good thing. Sometimes it's not, but there's consequences to every action.
She's not wrong. She's not wrong at all.
So, Haytham. What is your plan?
Well, one, call Matthias, call Invictus, see what kind of favors I can pull for the things we've just done for them. It's a little soon, but, you know, it doesn't hurt to ask. Two, Jason knows somebody. I don't know who he knows, but I need to figure that out and see if they can help us with this situation. And then, three, after gathering everything I know and, you know, doing a supply count, you know, starting to assemble a plan of action. Four, hopefully get it done before I start the siege of my club in the attempt to get it back. So, game plan is get information, make a plan, save the pup. Hopefully things are good, and then, you know, and then the next conflict begins.
All right. If you need anything, if you need even me to speak to Matthias, I can.
Okay. Yeah, it seems like y'all have a longer history. That would actually help a lot.
Continue doing things for him if he asks of you. But I will speak to him. And because we are now having conflict with the Crone, we are allies. So, if you can get confirmation, any sort of confirmation that they have this Nina, and you can give it to me, or at least show me anything, even for Matthias himself, that will save you in the long run in terms of vampire politics, and also for a just cause for us to even start conflict.
Understandable. I will get what I can.
All right.
Well, it seems like the sun's gonna be coming up soon, and I can already feel the UV in the air, so I gotta disappear to the trailer for the night, Mama Loba.
Good night. And again, if you need anything, let me know.
Will do. All right, Caden, we gotta get inside before we die. I pick up Caden, and I like fireman carry him on my shoulders. We're gone.
Okay.
Relax, kid. I just don't need you burning in the sunlight before we can even go get the pup.
As you both start heading back, or heading towards the trailer, and soon into the trailer, why don't you both roll a perception?
Hayden's too freaked out by suddenly being picked up. He doesn't see shit.
I got a major, a 9, and then a 1. No. I got a 10, 9, 8. And then I got a 1. So.
You, Haytham, you can see from, like, the corner of your eye as you're making your way carrying your little crippled friend. I can say this because I'm crippled.
My son. I'm carrying my son on my shoulders. Come on, boy. We're going to the park.
You can see two familiar faces that are walking together.
Are they holding hands still?
Are you asking me? Sorry. Yeah. Sure.
Haytham. He sees them walking out the corner of his eye, and then he turns his head. You know, he's like... A look of wide-eyed surprise comes on. He's like... Lily! You finally did it! Oh my god!
What?
Nothing, Spaz. She knows what I'm talking about.
Did you see that? She, like, lets go. She lets go of Spaz's hand.
Hate them face goes from... No. Really? Really? And then he's just gonna be like, you know what? Never mind. He's just gonna see you walking towards the trailer.
What happened
with Palma Lobo? It's a lot. Tell you tomorrow. I got a knock on my door.
But son of a bitch!
Sorry, I was just a little too loud. People trying to lay down. Well, it's a lot, so we will talk, tomorrow. I need rest, and I can feel the sun starting to burn my poor skin. Oh.
Okay, sleep well.
We'll do.
What time is it? Is it like...
I think after all of this commotion, it's about... About 4. Like, just turning 4 a.m. It's gone a lot. It's gone a lot faster than you think. So. I assume with that, the two vampires are going into the trailer.
Yes.
That's kind of gay, by the way. Anyway.
I sent him down as soon as we get inside.
You said...
Really?
He's the one who decided to fireman carry me to the trailer.
Everybody shut the fuck... What? What's best?
Okay, well, I was about to say something now. Hey, Lily. Do you want to sleep over at my trailer?
But I got... There is like like a just red as you say that.
Tomato.
It's redder than your hair. Sure.
She's glowing. She is literally glowing with how red she is.
I hope Caden's like right beside him also.
It's okay, Lily, I'm just teasing.
you're funny. I mean, I wouldn't mind. I'm just gonna shut up. I'm sorry.
What can I imagine? Spaz like Peter Griffin laughing, then just like doing like a little runaway, like just fucking taking off.
What did you say, Spaz? I didn't hear because fucking Vajra was talking.
Welcome.
I mean, you know what? Fuck it. And you see that she grabs your head again, Spaz, and then just starts pulling you towards your trailer.
We're not watching Space Jam again, though. We gotta watch something different this time. Like, I am so tired of Space Jam.
What do you have in mind? She's saying this as she's walking, by the way.
Have you ever seen Breakfast Club?
Yeah, I've seen that one. Why, do you want to watch that?
Sure.
Christ. Anyway. So, with that being said, Spaz, you and Lily make your way back to your trailer. And the two kindred stay in Hatham's trailer.
I go to my room by myself, and that's pretty useful.
Damn, I was hoping for another ship.
No, sorry.
I'm pretty sure Hatham sees Kaden as like a baby.
That is indeed a child, if anything. That's assumed to be son.
Oh. Like, oh no. Oh no. Well, have you seen Nico Para? Have you seen Nico Para?
You're wrong. Disgusting.
Oh no. Oh no.
So it's gonna be a Mulan situation. Oh, I'll make a man out of you. There's gonna be a whole training scene and everything. I'm gonna keep kicking his cane out from under him. Like, stand up straight! You don't need that cane no more! Cane's on the ground, please. I cannot move.
Oh my god, dude. But that being said, we could end the session here.
Yes, I must sleep.
It is a good time.
Yeah.
For like everything to end like end of night.
Yeah.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye. Go away. Bye.
10 out of 10.
Well. And we'll get to start the next session on a new day. Yeah. I won't be here.
We'll find a way. Wait, no, you're gonna be in Washington.
I'll make some. I'll talk to you. Said we can like plan something like.
Have an early session.
Off stream.
Have an early session. What?
Sydney, I'm gonna be leaving. What, you wanna have a session Wednesday?
I mean.
Cause I'm leaving Thursday.
I have to ask everybody. So.
Oh. Angel, goodbye.
But, that being said, I'm gonna end the stream here. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. This was a great session. And mind you, just as my title says, I didn't prep anything. I didn't prep shit. I had a basic idea and ran with it.
So, stream, what she's basically saying is me, the wonderful Pablo, and Beans carried this session. You're welcome. Our roses. Thank you very much.
I hate all of you. I hate every single one of you.
Why do you hate me?
Because you're associated with them. I'm just kidding.
I don't hate you.
Damn, what did I do?
Cool.
You know, I'm not even gonna say what you did. Anyway. Anyway.
Y'all make me sick.
What? Shove, Vajay. Anyway, so, good night, everybody. Please check out all the awesome players that are here. We got Furry Wasabi as Spaz. We got fucking Vajay plays as Haytham. We got Private Beans as Kaden. We've got the other players who are not here, which is Jason, which is LED Lights. And we've got, and we've also got Blanco, who is Lunar Law. And we have Guy as Kaiser, if I could find his username, fuck. I'm the best DM and the best streamer in the world. 10 out of 10 would recommend. No, I wouldn't. 2 seconds, I'm finding his username. Username is Kaiser. I have no idea what his name is. Kaiser Stratego. There we go. But yeah. Anyway, have a good night.
It took you just a little too long.
I was scrolling through all my shit.